What you see before you is a pot with water. We're going to go on a long journey with this recipe, but you're going to make something to impress family for Thanksgiving. Years ago, I made a recipe for a puree of acorn squash, butternut squash, and sweet potato to be different for Thanksgiving. That went over well, but that was simple. This is not simple. This is Dauphine potatoes made with sweet potatoes. And I usually put out everything in front of you, the recipe, but I'm going to do it step by step because this is complicated. So first off, we have the potatoes, the sweet potatoes, and we're going to boil them. Once this is boiled and seasoned and everything is mixed into the potato, then we're going to make a pate choux. And a pate choux you've eaten before, not knowing the name maybe, eclairs, profiteroles, that's made with pate choux. So that's mixed 50-50, potato mixture and the pate choux, and then you make little balls, or you can form them with a pastry bag to be fancy, and then they're deep fried. Great looking presentation on a platter, and you'll surprise your company. So let me just get started with doing the first thing. Now I'm going to put a tablespoon of sea salt in there and the potatoes cut like so. You can cut them a little larger, you can cut them smaller, it really doesn't matter. And while that's cooking, I'm going to get the rest of the ingredients that's only to be mixed into the potatoes to give it a nice flavor. Then the potatoes will get cooled off. Now we take the potatoes. Actually, it didn't take long, maybe 15 minutes. The reason why I'm not dumping it into a colander, because I'm going to use this liquid. Instead of using water to make the pate choux, or you can use water and milk, what I'm going to do is use the potato water, which has flavor in it. Now into this, if you have a ricer, use it. You don't want to overdo it, but I am going to use my whip. If you see how easy that does. Now into that, I'm going to put some allspice and a little bit of butter. The amounts in the recipe. And then I'm going to let this cool a little bit. Then I'm going to add the egg yolks to it. And what did I do with the egg whites? You don't want to throw them out, so I'll have a nice egg white omelet for dinner. See how easy that mashes? I have a ricer. The only thing I dislike about the ricer, it's a pain in the to clean. And this way, this comes out smooth. Then we'll add the cheese, Parmesan cheese. And there's the egg yolks, all ready to go. But you don't want to put them in here when this is very hot. This is not that type of mix. A little more with this, and then I'm going to turn to a spoon. Because done with that. Now let's taste that. This has to taste good. This will need salt. And just a drop more of allspice. Now you have to understand that that's the amount of potatoes. Now it's almost that amount of pate choux that's gonna go, which will take away from the flavor of this. And we will put in there a teaspoon of salt. I have to remember to write this down immediately. And then we'll proceed. Now we'll get going on the pate choux. The water from the potatoes is in there and a low flame. We're going to add the flour, a little sugar, and a little salt. We're going to stir this. We're going to keep on stirring this and cooking it until it pulls away from the side. This only takes a couple of minutes. As you see, now this right here is what you make the eclairs out of, or the profiteroles. Like I said, it comes away from the sides easily. I want everything. Give me a little piece. And then this is going to cool for a few minutes, because if you put the whole eggs in there now, what are we going to have? We're going to have scrambled eggs. Same thing goes with the potatoes. If I put the egg yolks in there too soon, we'll have scrambled egg yolks. That's it, done. Shut that off. Now let's go over to the, pull this off, put this on, put the egg yolks in there, and mix that up well. And then this is ready to be mixed with the pate choux. Get a deep fryer going. Not that quick. We're going to let this entire mix cool after the pate choux is added. So right now I'm going to put this in the refrigerator. Just to get a little head start. I'm going to wait a few minutes, so we'll shut this film off. Now I'm going to add the egg, one at a time, the eggs. Nice and warm, not too hot. So, we add an egg, and mix. There. That's the reason why you have a whip. A lot of eggs in this recipe. It's four in this alone, and then there are six egg yolks in the potatoes. But the eggs keep everything together. If you had no eggs and you put this in the deep fryer, it would just separate and go all over. I have my oil starting to heat up slowly. Now you can see why they say you either do this with a pastry bag because it's not a dough like normal doughs, like do-re-mi. And then we're going to mix this into the potatoes. Now I'm going to add the potato to the pate choux. Easier to get this out of this pan than it is removing the pate choux. This is still warm because you don't want to combine hot to cold, cold to hot. So these two are the same temperature right now. To this mixture, I'm going to add potato flour, because the sweet potatoes are very watery compared to white potatoes. And I will taste this. Now I'm going to slowly add potato flour. Well, I'm going to keep on adding the flour. This will take a few minutes until it's thick enough where you could actually take it, put it in a pastry bag with a large star tip and make a nice form. And then you deep fry it. But I'm using an ice cream scoop. Okay, that took me a few minutes. But as you can see, that's thick. Now we're going to cool this off and then get ready to fry. Let's start frying. We got 365 on the thermometer. I'm I hope to maintain that temperature. It's nice when you have a real deep fryer and you set the temperature and it'll stay there. Golden brown, take them out, and then you can take these the next day from a cookie sheet pan and heat them up, then sprinkle on top a little cinnamon and sugar mixed together, or just powdered sugar, and present them on a platter. See, we lost some of our temperature. But we'll keep on going. Well, this is what they look like, and what I'll do is, of course, I'll put the amount that I make, but we're done. That's it. I hope you enjoy.